Okay. We will have a quick look at the Cubase equalizer. And as you know, an equalizer is just a piece of equipment to change frequencies in your audio. Now, how to do this with the default Cubase equalizer? You go to a track. In this case, we take the vocal track, and you click on this E button again, so from Edit Channel Settings. So there are always two buttons to edit. So that is the Edit Channel Settings, and the other one is the Edit Instrument. And sometimes it's kind of confusing because here it is called Edit Instrument, while in the Virtual Instrument Panel, the E button is the Edit Instrument. So, but either way, if you want to do editing of a specific track, you can do Edit Channel or Edit Instrument. Now, so we now go to this audio track and we do Edit Channel, and then this window will open, and what you see here now in the middle, that is the default Cubase equalizer, and this is a so-called four-band equalizer and parametric equalizer, as it is called. And that can now be used to change certain frequencies. Now it has four different bands, and they can be switched on, and they can be switched off. Now, and forget about the pre, as it is called here, for the, and it's basically a cutoff at the end and at the beginning, and a gain of your channel, and a button for changing the phase. You're not going to use that. But you see now we have activated all four channels of this equalizer, and now we can boost specific frequencies, for example at 500 Hz, and we can reduce the bass a bit, and maybe we can add a little bit more of the higher frequencies. Now that is basically how it works. And instead of doing it by the mouse, you can also just type in your values for the gaining. This is the frequency, and then the bottom one is the so-called Q factor that determines the width of the band that you are seeing. So for example, here we have the second band, so this one, and we can make it smaller or broader with just by the mouse or typing in a value. And what you also see is that there are different shapes for all these different bands. So for example, this is a shelving equalizer, the lowest one, but also that can be changed to a parametric one, so then you have a thing like that. Or you can do a high pass filtering, so you get something like this. And also for the other bands, you can kind of change the shape and then do whatever needs to be done to get a better sound for this for the audio track that you are now manipulating. Okay, so this is how it works. In the next video, we will see a different way of using another equalizer. Thanks.